enable.
Welcome to our special series, Inspirational Brands Make in India. Through this show, we put the spotlight on companies from various verticals that are contributing significantly to the government's Make in India mission.
When it comes to fashion, we all want to pick the best. And one brand that is making this choice easier for men by staying true to contemporary styles and wardrobe essentials is Blackberry's. Founded in 1991 in the bustling bylanes of Chandni Chowk as a garment manufacturer, Blackberry's today has grown into a leading menswear fashion brand in India with a turnover of over 900 crore rupees. With its customer base spread across the country, Blackberry's has a presence in over 350 Indian cities and has grown at a compounded growth rate of 17% in the last 5 years. From trousers, suits and jackets for formal occasions, to shirts, shoes, accessories and more, Blackberry's is committed to redefining occasion wear and casual wear as per the modern Indian man's growing fashion needs. A brand associated with innovation and sharp contemporary style, Blackberry's provides wardrobe solutions and products that are aimed at positively augmenting one's personality. For the founders and directors of Blackberry's, Nikhil Mohan and Nitin Mohan, creating their own brand was a choice that came with no surprises. Alumni of NIF Delhi, the brothers have been the brains behind this leading menswear brand, delivering the highest level of excellence in customer service.
And now I'm in conversation with the founders and directors of Blackberry's, Nikhil and Nitin Mohan, right here at one of their flagship stores in New Delhi. Welcome, gentlemen. It's a pleasure to have you with us on the show.
Yes, same here.
First up, your family has been in the clothing business for over 130 years. Was it a natural choice for both of you to be entrepreneurs in this space in particular?
We still run a store which is 125 years old in Chandni Chowk, and that's really where the brand took roots. Retailing of men's textile is what we understood, what was the dinner table conversation whenever the family got together. And I think that's where we learned the nitty-gritties of the warp and the weft, the soft and the worsted, the various kind of wools and cottons that are there. So, and I think it was only natural that we forward integrated from retailing to brand, which is where we are today. So 1991 is when Blackberry started as a brand, and it's been a fantastic journey.
So 1991, it's been about 27 years since Blackberry's was established as a brand. You moved, like he said, from wholesale to retail to becoming a leading fashion brand of sorts now. So today, what is the brand identity of Blackberry's? What is your USP like?
Convenience and experimentation of clothing, of fabric into garment, now into lifestyle, and now as we speak expressing himself through what he wears. So he wants to indicate his success, he wants to indicate his style through the clothes that he wears. Our man has many moods. He is looking for diverse clothing to be perfect on that boardroom meeting, for that wedding reception, and so on.
So that's a lot of diverse moods that you're talking about. Today, what are the various segments that the brand targets?
We've been known for formal wear all along, and this is the right time to get into casual wear, and that's where Blackberry's Urban comes in, and also Blackberry's Casual. So while Urban, we address the younger audience, which is the 18 to 25 age group, which is very, very cutting edge, very fashionable, which has the spirit of a wanderer and the spirit of a dreamer.
Right.
So this is aimed at the youngsters. At the other end, Blackberry's Casual, which is inspired by travel, and travel is a way of life. So for entrepreneurs who dress sharply, who carry their attitude very well, that's where BlackBerry's casual comes in.
And you've chosen very clearly to focus on menswear only. Why is that? Why no entry into the women's wear segment? I understand women are more difficult to please as far as clothes are concerned. So
we believe that in this competitive environment, one needs to be a specialist. And I think the value that we bring for the man in India is immense, and we would like to be known as a specialist. Though we understand that women's wear is clearly a much faster growing category at this point, as women move from ethnic to more Western wear and they move out of homes, but we are sticking to men's wear.
What's the biggest challenge according to you in the Indian men's wear retail market?
The number one is it's hyper competitive. There are many players, many formats. Though, having said that, the number of garments that are available that are finding its way into wardrobe are also increasing.
Yeah.
And as mentioned earlier, men have many moods, they have many, many needs for garments. So on one hand, you have a greater degree of competition. On other hand, there is a far greater need to buy diverse garments.
You've chosen to focus specifically on the youth. So what sort of design sense and what sort of style sense do you adopt to, tap that category, considering that 65% of Indians are under the age of 35 years right now?
So we have a very youthful team actually working at BlackBerry's, who looks at fashion, who looks at color, who looks at silhouette from various lenses. I'd like to share that fit is very experiential and very critical part of men's clothing, and a jacket is like a three-dimensional garment. And the fits are getting slimmer, they are getting sharper, and they so one is you go to the gym and stay fit, and the other is the responsibility
you
that
wear clothing
you take
that
to
makes you look
wear
slim.
Clothing that makes you look smart and slim.
Right. Today, how large is BlackBerry's footprint? How many stores are you present in? How many cities? What is the footprint like?
So we are available in nearly 350 cities. We run around 200 of our own brands, which would be amongst the largest player running their own retail outlets. We also are adding franchise outlets. That's another 50 odd. So our concentration is now focused towards tier 2 and tier 3.
Right.
This is where the one can sense a pent-up demand coming up.
So talking of distribution and distribution channels, how big a role does e-commerce play in your distribution? How are you leveraging digital? And going forward, is that going to be your major channel of distribution, or will brick and mortar still rule?
For now, brick and mortar is a very large part of the business. But digital is a very interesting space in a couple of aspects. One is that the consumer of today likes to interact with the brand on the digital. So the first interactions are happening digitally. At the other end, as far as engaging with the consumer is concerned, so it is no more bombarding the consumer with one-sided conversation. So it is more engagement, it is more a two-way process. And digital allows us to interact with the consumer on that front.
Just to add to that, so we've added a convenience feature in this digital landscape. So there is omni-channel, which is at work. So you can, if you do not find an article, say, in this store, our guys will organize it, access it digitally, and give confidence to the customer and deliver it at his residence.
Wonderful. And as far as technology in manufacturing is concerned, have you, over the years, overhauled your manufacturing facilities with and keeping pace with advanced technology on the manufacturing floor as well?
And so, of course, today's age and time for the men's classic clothing is they are actually engineered garments. So right from pattern making to cutting to sewing, finishing, and warehouse and logistics. So there's a lot of technology, a lot of applications, lot of machinery that's come in, which is automated. Some of it is with artificial intelligence. They have great memory. human interface is slightly is not required so much, and the machines are helping us doing that.
Great. Okay, so on that note, we are going to take a short break right now, but the conversation with the Mohan brothers of BlackBerries continues on the other side. So stay tuned to Inspirational Brands Make in India.
To match the looks of various genres and lifestyles, BlackBerries offers a range of apparel with its three brands, BlackBerries Formals, BlackBerries Casual, and Urban BlackBerries. While the Formals collection is all about impressive boardroom attire, Casual is an expression of casual dressing at work, leisure, and travel. And Urban BlackBerries caters to new age millennial youth, complementing their confident and expressive side of dressing.
Welcome back to Inspirational Brands Make in India, a special series that explores tales of business success. On the show today, I'm talking to the Mohan brothers, founders and directors of leading fashion and apparel brand BlackBerries. One of the things that your brand has recently done is to overhaul its logo, its tagline. What was the thought behind this rebranding process, and what's the objective you're trying to achieve with it?
We did our research on the 25th year, figuring out what customers expect out of BlackBerries.
Right.
So we were quite humbled by the fact that they love the brand because they know that we have risen from humble backgrounds and we are fighting against the biggest of corporates in menswear industry. And surprisingly, we were mirroring their journey as well. So together we believe that we can fight against all odds, and Firebird is our new logo, which represents this relentless pursuit of success that we will not stop at any finishing line and go on. So that is the spirit of the brand. So earlier, if I could add, we were more about the product. Now it is the emotional connect with our consumers, and we want to partner them in their journey of success.
So along with rebranding, you've also got a new tagline called Keep Rising. What does that stand for? What was the thought behind that?
So we see the journey of our customer moving from one challenge to another, moving from one success to other. And we don't see him resting on his laurels, resting on what he's achieved in past. And so we will continue to partner our customer, exhort our customer to keep reigniting his passion, to keep reinventing himself, and to keep rising.
Okay, and you've seen a significant growth over the last 5 years. What's that growth trajectory been like for you? And going forward, what do you think are going to be your key growth drivers?
So moving from one brand to three brands is, so that's where BlackBerries Formal, BlackBerries Casual, and Urban come in, where we address the youth of today, one in the office wear and the formal segment, and the other is the lifestyle casual. We are also going closer to the customer, so through zonal offices and empowered teams which operate out of 5 regions out of Delhi. We would continue to understand the local demand and the local play that happens on the ground, and tailor our merchandise, tailor our communication to address these local demands.
Any plans of stepping out of India and making the product available overseas?
At this point in time, I think India offers ample opportunity for growth. There are many segments that one can go, many geographies. So at this point in time, no.
So what are your expansion plans within India in the next couple of years? What's the production capacity like today? Are you planning to expand that as well?
A lot of manufacturing already happens in-house, and we run the facilities. At the same time, over the years, we worked closely with the design team at textile mills, with our manufacturing partners, and there are capacities which are very, very committed to us, and there is a great sense of understanding with these partners. At another end, other than manufacturing, we are also working closely with our digital partners, with our customer relationship service advisors, and with interior designers who help us do our store. And so a lot of expansion on that side. Also on warehousing and logistics is becoming increasingly important. Time is of great value. So there are warehouses coming in the southern part of the country, which will help localize distribution. And the aim is to hit 83% of our population within 4 days. So the time from order to delivery at doorstep, we are wanting to keep it at 4 days for the entire country.
Wonderful. So how many new stores can we expect by the end of financial year 2018?
So between company operated stores and FOFO stores, it is just not a number, but 35 here and 65 of FOFO, so adds up to 100. I'm happy to share that this figure last year was close to 55. So it seems to be a very achievable
number.
Almost
doubling it this year.
But still achievable number.
Now, the government has launched an ambitious mission of Make in India, trying to make India a global manufacturing hub. And as far as the manufacturing, garment manufacturing sector is concerned, what are the top three challenges you think that need immediate addressing that gives us a sort of, a leapfrog on the garment manufacturing front?
Garment is a very intensive as far as manpower is concerned. So clearly, and this is also for domestic, it's also a seasonal business. It's slightly lopsided in its demand. So for us to continuously provide employment to a set number of workers is a challenge. So we would definitely want little flexibility on that side.
Right.
The other is there is the financial interest rates are also, it's a pretty tight regime, and these costs are of operations are mounting on a phenomenal rate over last 5-6 years. So this, the interest costs adds up to the entire cost environment. So any easing in financial regime will definitely help the business.
How difficult is it to find skilled manpower, because in India we are at a stage where we need more and more jobs for the youth entering the workforce every year. At the same time, industry often feels that people are not industry ready and they are not skilled enough to be employed. What's the scene like as far as garment manufacturing?
So there was a time when we used to ferry people in buses from one location to the factories and to the plants, but it has improved dramatically over the years. So whether it is operators who work on the machines or whether it is the designers and merchandisers who are now trained at institutes like NIFT and other government initiatives. So this is getting better, but the pace at which the industry is going, the expansion plans that one has, there still is a gap between demand and supply.
Okay, from here on, what's your vision for BlackBerries? Where do you want to take it, say, in the next 5 to 8 year horizon?
House of BlackBerries with all the brands is going to be the telling force as far as menswear is concerned. It will be amongst the top three in the segments that it competes. For this house of brands to be more relevant to people, we have to obviously go into more categories, more customer segments, and perhaps add more brands to our kitty. So going forward, this will be a play of brands which are available at numerous price points and geographies.
Thank you so much, Nikhil and Nitin. It's been a pleasure talking to both of you. Thank you so much for being with us on the show.
Wonderful to be on your show.
Well, with that, it's a wrap of this episode of Inspirational Brands Make in India. We'll be back next time with yet another exciting tale of business success. Till then, thanks for joining us. Goodbye.